Hello? You are welcome to Living Food. The Lord who is jealous over us is here providing us this precious time to touch His living oracles. May He establish His counsel as you listen to us week after week. This edition of Living Food continues our studies on the Christian home. We desire to look furthermore on the relationship, roles and responsibilities of the husband and the wife in the home. May the Lord set your feet on the solid path of responsible domestic living. If you desire to have these classes, you can be directed on how to purchase them if you indicate interest. Let's pray along with you and counsel with you over any difficulty you may have. And do remember our discipleship by correspondence program. Request for the enrollment form if you so desire. Our address is Living Seed, PO Box 971, Boko, Benue State, Nigeria. Living Seed, PO Box 971, Boko, Benue State, Nigeria. As you bow down to pray and receive this message from the Lord, I invite our Bible teacher on this program, Brother GBILE AKANNI, to bring us the Word of God. Brother GBILE, shall we pray together? Our Father and our God, how we honor you today for your very presence with us. Thank you, Lord, for the provision of your Word to us. For the Bible says that Word is a lamp unto our feet. Thy word is the instrument by which you provide immediate step-by-step direction unto whosoever will want to follow you. And here, O God, concerning our homes and families, thank you for providing the word of God to guide us to fashion and design our homes that you may achieve your desired goals. Lord, today, we are praying for ourselves, we are praying for our listeners, that God, your presence, your spirit, will break the word and bring forth in life, bring it forth in power, bring it forth in grace, that all those who listen to us, something definitely may happen to them, happen to their families, happen to their relationship, in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, at the end of this study, we are praying that it will bring an increase unto your church, to bring a definite, measurable development unto our families, unto our brethren, wherever they are, even today. Thank you for hearing us, for we know you have done it, since you have asked in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. I want to thank God for yet another opportunity to come your way today. We believe it is God who is providing for us, especially His word that we bring to you from week to week. We are praying that as you listen, may it mix with faith in your soul, that it might do you good and cause you to advance definitely towards the purpose of God for your life and especially for your family. Today, I want to go ahead dealing with correct relationships, roles and responsibility in the family or in the Christian home. And today I will be dealing with relationships. I will be dealing with what exactly is supposed to be the pattern of relationship between husband and wife. After which, as the Lord leads us, we will now begin to deal with the roles and the responsibilities of the individual member of the Christian home. May God grant us understanding as we go ahead today in the name of Jesus Christ. Again, I want you to refer back to the text we have been studying. We have been studying Genesis chapter 2, and today we will read verse 21 up to 25, and Matthew 19 from verse 4 to 6. After reading from Genesis, Genesis chapter 2, and from verse 21. And the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon Adam, and he slept. And he took one of his ribs and closed up the flesh instead thereof. And the rib which the Lord God had taken from man made it a woman and brought her unto the man. And Adam said, This is now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man. Therefore shall a man leave his father and his mother, and shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh. And they were both naked, the man and his wife, and were not ashamed. Look at Matthew 19, verse 4 to 6. And he said and answered unto them, Have you not read that he which made them at the beginning made them male and female, and said, For this cause shall a man leave father and mother, and shall cleave to his wife, and they twain shall be one flesh. Wherefore they are no more twain, but one flesh. What therefore God has joined together, let not man put asunder. May God grant you understanding, even as we look into the word today, in the name of Jesus Christ. Now, I want to go on looking at the relationship between husband and wife. And I want to say that the goal of the relationship, your interaction, as far as God is concerned, is becoming one flesh. Becoming one flesh. Now, if you look at Genesis 2 again, the Bible says, And Adam said, This is now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man. Therefore shall a man leave his father and his mother, and shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall become one flesh. Now I'm trusting that even as we go on through these scriptures, definite things will begin to dawn on your heart in the name of Jesus Christ. Now from the Genesis scripture we have read, in order not to repeat what we have said some weeks ago, we realize that the making of the wife, which God did on behalf of the man, he took one of his ribs and closed up the flesh instead thereof. And the rib which the Lord God had taken made him a woman and brought her unto the man. Now, but I want us to emphasize from verse 23, and I will not waste time on it, because I have spoken about this again and again in the course of this series. And Adam said, This is now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man. Now, the first understanding, and a clear and thorough understanding that must dawn on you in order for the two to become one flesh. Number one is for you to realize what Adam saw in the scripture, especially in that verse 23. He said, This is now bone of my bones. I want God to help you to understand today that you see, the wife that God is bringing to your life, it doesn't matter where she grew up, and I will be illustrating that as time goes on. It doesn't matter where she was brought. If it was God that brought her to your life, if it was God that made this arrangement, if you waited on God and God did it for you, I'd like to say to you that she is the bone of your bones, the flesh of your flesh. That is, she is part and parcel of your life. Every husband should look at their wife not as one outside entity that is just coming to deal with them, that is just coming to share with them. No. I want you to begin to understand that this woman is but an expression, an extension of your life. She is the bone of your bones and the flesh of your flesh. She is called woman, not because of what she does, not because of how she will help you, not because of what she will do for you, but because she is basically taken out of you. She has been brought in to fill up the gap that is in your life. We have said that, but you need to keep knowing that every day. The moment you do not remember that this woman is not just with me, she is of me. We are one. together. If you separate her from me, there will be a loophole in my life. If she runs away or I should abandon her, I have abandoned a vital part of my life. There is need for that understanding. Madam, I also would like you to think and understand what we are saying, that you are the bone of his bones. God has brought you in to fit in. That is the only man you can fit into. By the grace of God, when we look at your roles, you begin to understand this better by the grace of God. If you look at Ephesians 5 and verse 30, Ephesians 5, 30, you will again see the same idea, the same thought repeated in the New Testament. Ephesians 5, 30. Can I quickly read that? For we are members of his body, of his flesh, and of his bones. For this cause shall a man leave his father and mother, and shall be joined unto his wife, and they two shall be one flesh. May God grant you understanding in the name of Jesus. Now go quickly to verse 24 now. Go quickly to verse 24. Verse 24 now said, therefore shall a man leave his father and his mother, and shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh. I want to deal with some few words that determine the proper relationship in the family in this particular Bible verse. The first word here is therefore. I want all of you to underline therefore in your Bible, if you have a Bible there. Therefore, now you will notice that therefore in Genesis chapter 2 verse 24 also is repeated somehow in Matthew chapter 19 verse 5. In Genesis chapter 19 verse 5, it comes in like this. It said, For this cause, that is because of this, that is the meaning of therefore, shall a man leave father and mother, and shall cleave to his wife, and they twain shall be one flesh. Now, and if you go to Ephesians chapter 5, again you will see the word for this cause in verse 31. For this cause shall a man leave his father and mother, and shall be joined unto his wife, and they two shall be one flesh. Now what is the meaning of therefore? Therefore means for this reason, for this cause. So my first question which I'm dealing with now is for which cause? For which cause? Is there any reason for a proper relationship between husband and wife? What is the therefore of relationship as a family? What is the therefore of this relationship that we are talking about? And I'm trusting that the Holy Spirit will cross your eyes to see it. You will discover that verse 23 of chapter 2 of Genesis said, this now is the bone of my bones and the flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman because she was taken out of man. Therefore, now if you look at Matthew 19 verse 4, it says, have you not read that he which made them at the beginning made them male and female? For this cause shall a man leave father and mother. And Ephesians chapter 5 also said, for we are members of his body, of his flesh, and of his bones. For this cause shall a man leave his father and mother. Now what is that therefore? In chapter 2 of Genesis, we are discovering this, that the therefore of marriage is because that woman is the bone of your bones. I have said earlier on that every man had a missing rib in his life. I have said that no matter how educated you are, no matter how independent you are, no matter how self-sufficient you think you are, there is a loophole in your life. There is a missing rib in your life. And that missing rib, actually, until it is brought back, you are not complete. You will never balance. No matter how you are tired of your wife, let your wife go away, you will soon discover that there is a lack in your life. Some of you may not want to acknowledge that, because you think that if you acknowledge that, your wife will be proud and will be bragging about you. No, please stop kidding.
Face the reality. There is a reason why you need to cling to your wife. It is because she is the bone of your bones. She is the flesh of your flesh. She is the person that comes in to complete your life, to make your life full and fulfilled, to make your destiny complete. It looks to me as if until she comes in, until she signs along with you, your check, as I said last week, will remain bound in the bank of heaven. Therefore, shall a man leave his father and mother and cleave unto his wife, and the two of them shall become one flesh. It's like this. When that woman comes in, that's when you become complete. You don't become two people, actually. You become one whole. The woman herself is not complete. All the other parts of her life, all other bones or her bones, is located in the husband. And until she fitted into that man, she will remain a misfit anywhere else. Those of you women listening to me, that I see you running after other people's husbands, you are sleeping with them, giving them your life, I want to say you are a misfit. Those of you that have married someone that I married before, you are stealing another person's husband. Madam, I must tell you without sharing your face, you are a misfit. That is not the bone of your bones. You are a misfit in that place. And I don't think you will ever find peace. I don't think you will ever find fulfillment until you get out of that condition. Until you get out of that situation, it will never be alright. You see, what is the therefore of marriage here? It is because that woman you see is the bone of your bones. Now, so having said that, I now say that your relationship with your wife is not optional. Please understand that now. Your harmonious relationship with your wife is not whether you like it or not. Except you don't want to have peace. Except you don't want to be complete. Except you don't want to be fulfilled. Except you don't want your prayers to be answered. That's when you can treat this relationship with levity. Here the Bible says, therefore shall a man. Now, so the next thing I want to deal with, the Bible says, shall a man. And I'm coming by God's grace later on to look at why did God say a man. But I want to say this. It is natural that we think it is the woman that should leave her father and mother and come to be following the man up and down. But I like to say to you, you don't marry into your family. May God help you to understand that. There are so many men. The reason why your home is breaking is because you forgot that this woman, she is the bone of your bones. And it is only you that she was designed to fit into. Not to fit into your mother. Not to fit into your father. Not to fit into your junior brothers and your senior brothers. And there are so many men today. They just marry their wife for the family. Some just say, "Kai, my mother is suffering so much. Let me marry a wife so that I will just dump for her so that she can be cooking for my mother." I'm sorry to tell you that that's not the purpose of God for marriage. If you wanted a cook for your old mother, please go and rent one. If you wanted someone to be fetching firewood and water for your old parents, please go and rent someone. A steward will do that job better. You don't have to be your wife. Are you hearing me? If you must marry at all, you must be ready to take a responsible step in building that relationship. Are you following what I'm saying today? Marriage is not into family. It's not into extended family. Not everybody in your father's house is the husband to your wife. Are you hearing me? You are not expected that your wife will fit into every life in your house. No way. That's not how God designed it. The Lord designed it that this woman will fit into your life and your life particularly. If the two of you will relate with your family, you will be relating as one entity. It is not correct that you expose your wife to the family calls, to the family troubles. You say, "Look, go and meet my uncle there. Go and meet my auntie there. Go and talk to my brother there." No, please. That's not the way God wanted that relationship to be. That relationship is supposed to be peculiar to you. And then you and your wife, you become one flesh. And as one entity, you relate with your father. As one entity, you relate with your mother. As one entity, you relate with everybody around. It's not a situation where somebody is married and she's going back to her mother's house. And almost every time, she's dashing back home and to take instruction from her father and her mother. You know, it's not possible that way. And the two of them shall become one flesh. May God grant you understanding in the name of Jesus. The next word I want to deal with, you can see it there. It said, therefore, shall a man live. Let's quickly look at the word live. What's the meaning of live? To live means to let go. To live means to move out. The Bible says, for this cause shall a man live. You see, the umbilical cord, are you following me, please? When you were in your mother's womb, there's something that tied you together with your mother. It was the umbilical cord. And no child will ever have been alive if that umbilical cord was not cut. When the umbilical cord was cut and you were removed from your mother's womb, it meant that you are ready to live an independent life. You are ready to live independent of your mother, independent of your father. But then there is someone that God has arranged, God has designed, God has prepared to fit into this your life, that you might become complete. And that person is that woman, is that wife that God is leading you to, that God has brought into your life. Are you following what I'm saying today? Now the Bible said, when you discover that your bone, because you cannot share your attention between the two. Are you following me? You cannot share your attention between your wife and your mother. It's not possible. I'm going to illustrate that with a story that will give you understanding later on by the grace of God. Now, but I want you to see today, before I run this aspect up, the Bible said, he will leave. You are going to leave. Let them go. Regardless of how you really love the way your mother used to cook for you, you are going to leave that behind. No matter how sweet your mother's soup used to be, excuse me, you are married. It is no more your mother's soup that you are going to eat. It must be your wife. Are you hearing me? It is no longer your father's stories. You are going to sit down listening. And there are so many premature husbands in our society today. Every little problem, they are going to their father. Every little problem, they are running home. They say, Daddy, I don't understand what my wife is doing to me. And they start crying. Excuse me, when you are not here mature enough to leave your father, to leave your mother, then I tell you, you are not qualified to marry. You are not qualified to marry. Marriage is not for small boys. Are you hearing me? That's why the Bible says, shall the man, not the boy. Those of you that are boys, wait until you mature. Those of you that are girls, wait until you mature. Those of you that cannot take care of yourself, talk less of taking care of a wife, wait until you are mature. Marriage is for men, not for boys. Not for boys. You must be able to leave. When I say to leave father, to leave mother, you are going to leave them in terms of family support. You are going to leave them in terms of the place to sleep. I see some men, they marry into their father's house. And it is just one room that their father, he's sleeping in, that they also want to marry their wife into. Excuse me, you are not ready for marriage. You are not ready for marriage. If I see you planning and you are fixing your wedding, I want you to stop it. Stop it, because that is not correct. I'm not asking you that you should build a big mansion before you get married, but I want to tell you that marriage involves living. You must leave. You must leave whatsoever they meant to you, you will leave them. If you are not ready to leave them as a man, you are not ready to take in a wife. Are you understanding what I'm saying? The place, the room your father, your mother used to occupy in your heart, that's the place your wife must come in to occupy. Your wife will become your father, your mother, henceforth. Are you willing for such a thing? If you are not, I want you to reconsider your decision for marriage. May God help you in the name of Jesus. Now, what is the other word I want to conclude on there? It's a cleave. What's the meaning of cleave? The proclaim means to hold tightly, to grip and never to let go, to keep holding and grasping again and again, shall cleave, shall hold onto, shall glue onto. You see, the word cleave means to get glued inseparably, that nothing will be able to. You know, when the Bible says to cleave, it means there may be things that want to shake you, but you are cleaving. Shall cleave, shall hold tightly unto his wife. May God help you to understand that. As I perceive that our time is gone, I want to stop here. I'm trusting that God will help you to see this, that he shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh. Now, I want to ask you the following question. Do you think this marriage that you have entered into, you are handling it according to the manufacturer's design? Do you suppose the way you have been relating with your wife, is it correct? Do you discover her to be the bone of your bones and the flesh of your flesh? And for that reason, have you seen a reason? Therefore, why you must hold on to her, why you must leave everyone else, all your friends, all your boyfriends, all your girlfriends, you must leave them. Have you seen the reason? Or I see you say, well, I'm married, and at the same time, all your friends, they occupy all your time, they occupy all your affection. You just come home with leftovers, and your wife is wondering, am I a widow while my husband is still alive? As we pray together with you now. If you discover that, yes, what the word of God is saying about marriage, you have not done it, you have not lived like that, bow your heart. Begin to pray. The purpose for which this message is coming to you is for God himself to establish you and to return you back to original pattern. Bow your heart as our brother leads you in this short prayer. Our Father, we want to thank you, O God. We want to thank you for exposing us to this fact. Lord, we are praying, O God, for those outside there. They had mistreated their wives. They had thrown them to the wolves of their relatives, and Lord, they had cracked them. But Lord, today they are praying, they are asking for forgiveness. Lord, let there be a restoration. Let there, oh God, be a togetherness again. Let your purpose of these different marriages, oh God, be fulfilled. Thank you that, Lord, you will do this, for we have prayed in Jesus' name. Amen. The design of God is that only your wife can fit into you. She cannot fit into your father, your mother, or any of your relatives, but you alone. You must meet your people as a man, whatever they mean to you. Hold tight to your wife from today, never to let go, no matter the pressures. God bless you. Write us and request for the discipleship by correspondent program if you desire. Our address is Living Seed, PO Box 971 Boko, Benue State, Nigeria. Living Seed, PO Box 971 Boko, Benue State, Nigeria. God bless you.